Coronavirus has taken a wrecking ball to our economy, and today we found out just how badly it's battered the lives of so many Australians. In just 1 month, nearly 600,000 people lost their job, the single biggest mass sacking in history. Tonight, 2.7 million Australians are without work or are working greatly reduced hours. The Nine Network's political editor, Chris Yulman, begins our coverage.
Just days after lockdown, Troy lost his job and he hasn't worked since.
It's not horrible. It's not like I'm on the verge of death, but, you know, it's you know, quality of life has depleted a lot.
One desperate story among thousands on the Centrelink queues.
Pretty much everyone I know is, like, out of work, almost everyone.
Today, the breadth of that suffering was measured.
This is a tough day for Australia. A very tough day.
A day when the grim toll of the coronavirus cure was tallied. Nearly 600,000 people lost their jobs between March and April, the largest monthly fall in history. Officially, unemployment jumped by a percentage point from 5.2 to 6.2% as 104,000 people drove those on benefits to 823,330. But that's only a fragment of the pain. Total hours worked plunged 9.2%. So when all the numbers are combined, about 2.7 million people, or one in five of those who were employed in March, lost their jobs or had their wages cut by April. Only the wage subsidy safety net has stopped the jobless queues from lengthening to depression-era levels.
The number of employees covered by those businesses that are formally enrolled in the JobKeeper program now exceeds 6 million.
Add that to the unemployed, and over half of Australia's pre-virus workforce is now being paid by the government, and it's just the beginning.
And in the months ahead, we can brace ourselves and must brace ourselves for further hard news.
As nearly 30 years of growth ends in a shattering warp-speed recession.
And for many young people who have never experienced that, this is beyond anything they could imagine.
Labor says the experience has been made worse for those casuals, artists and university workers who can't claim the wage subsidy.
Aren't more Australians out of work today because the Prime Minister deliberately excluded them from the JobKeeper wage subsidy?
It doesn't take long, Mr Speaker, for the white handing to begin.
And for politics to return to normal service.
Okay, live to our political editor Chris Yulman at Parliament House. Chris, is this as bad as it's going to get?
Unfortunately, no, Pete. As heartbreaking as these numbers are, Treasury expects the jobless rate will rise to 10%, and the truly staggering number in all these figures is 6 million, and that's the number of people who are on the JobKeeper wage allowance. That means around about 800,000 businesses are now acting as welfare shop fronts for the government. Now, and in September, those numbers will really come home to roost when the payments end, and it's about the same time that a lot of the numbers which come with the business loans are expected to fall due. And if we're still living in a twilight economy of social distancing then, where businesses can't run to capacity, well, Pete, thousands will collapse and unemployment will soar.
OK, Chris, thank you.